Greetings, this is another video overview by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at two lights from Crelant that share the same interface, the Crelant 7G3CS and the 7G6CS. Now these are both 18650 class lights, or 2xCR123A camera battery lights. What they differ is in sort of the size and build and the max output between them. So here in front of me right now is the 7G6, a larger light, bigger head as you can see, and a deep reflector with a cool white XML emitter there at the base for maximum throw. Crenellated stainless steel bezel, stainless steel tail cap ring, although it still allows tail standing, standard kind of clip, and a dual interface, a forward tail cap switch clicky here in the tail cap, and an electronic switch in the head to change modes. I'll talk about the interface in a moment, but it's actually very similar to the 7G5CS I reviewed recently. The 7G3CS is a more petite version of the light. Believe it or not, this light will take 18650, so it is board wide enough for that. And this is meant, I think, to compete more with some of the other slimline 18650 lights that I've reviewed recently. Same sort of interface again. You have the same kind of tail cap switch, forward clicky. You have an electronic switch here in the head, and you have an XML emitter there, again, cool white, at the base of a much smaller reflector. But you know, fairly deep for this type of light, so still trying to maximize throw as much as possible compared to most other lights of the class, but obviously not going to be as much of a thrower here as the 7G6 right here. Before I get into the lights, I'll just kind of get the packaging out of the way. The 7G3 comes in a smaller box, as shown here, with sort of standard items you might expect. Standard kind of decent sort of quality wrist strap, extra O-rings in the package. It also comes with a clip, very similar looking to the clip you can see here on the 7G6, so that can fit on the light as you'd expect. Also with a manual, although in this case the manual, I don't know if you can see that, actually says the 7G6CS instead of the 7G3. Not that it matters, the actual interface is the same, but if you take a look at my full review, you can see what the detailed proper specs are for each model. It is kind of interesting though that they put the wrong manual in the box. For the 7G6, this is the more sort of standard Crelant packaging. You can see the specs are listed here on the side of the box. As before, again though, I recommend you check, you know, the actual review for the up-to-date specs. Much the same sort of package, again, same manual, and the same sort of, you know, accompanying items of a wrist strap, O-rings, and the clip, which is already on it. So basically, despite the fact the box looks a little different, they're very similar lights. There's a few differences on performance in terms of runtime and so forth, but you'll see that on the full review on my website. Build-wise, so one comment, I'll start with the 7G3 here. In order to keep the light as slim as possible, they've done this by not making the tail cap removable. So although that looks like it's a tail cap, it doesn't actually come apart. It's solid in there. You would presumably have to remove the stainless steel bezel ring, tail cap ring here to get at the switch. And you can see there's a switch down there. Maybe if I put a little bit more light on that. So it's a little bit bright, but you can get the idea. There's a tail cap switch down there at the base. There's a spring here in the head, so you can use flat top cells. So you just put the battery inside. There is unfortunately no anodization here on the head, so you can't lock this light out at the head. You change modes by the switch, and I'll go through all that again on the 7G6 in a moment. Overall, though, a fairly good slimline build. Knurling's not very aggressive, but there's enough here, and along with the switch, I find the overall grip isn't too bad. My one comment here, though, is that I would like to see anodized threads, if at all possible, especially since there's no tail cap clicky. I don't know how you can see that there. Maybe I'll hold it up a bit. But those look to be fairly good quality and actually square-cut threads. So all in all, not a bad build. Again, just that one point I would like to see about the anodization, just because it's always nice to have on a light. Let's go take you through now this 7G6. One extra feature here as well. You can see there is a metal clip ring here that's rotating through near the top. Be kind of hard to see that, so I'm going to get a better shot of it for you. You can see it just sort of up there at the top of the light. This light does have anodized threads, so we can put our battery in and lock out the light at the tail cap, which looks like a fairly traditional model. The light will, of course, also open at the head, and there that was actually clicked on. So just to show you the head first. Now, of course, these are not anodized because they don't need to be because it's anodized at the tail cap. As before, there's a spring there you can see on the head. So you can, again, use flat top cells. Okay, so use of the light. Click it on at the tail cap, light comes on. You can see here it's in high. Press the switch, or click and release, it's an electronic switch, and you get the low mode. Turn it again, you get into a standby off. Again, you come back on high, and you just cycle between high, low, and off. If you hold it on, and turn it on, and press and hold the switch, after a few second delay, the light begins to ramp. See, it ramps down, gets to a low level, holds it for a second or two, then ramps back up. This is the exact same pattern that I saw on my 7G5CS, and you'll see full details on the ramp. It flashes three times when you get to max. What's nice about this feature is that when you ramp the light back down, once you find a level you like, you just stop and hold it there, and it remembers. So if you cycle from what was previously high and now set to this level, to the defined low, the standby, and back to your defined level. So it remembers until you click the light off and on at the tail cap. When you turn it back on, there we go, we'll try this again. Oops, switch between modes. Actually, it seems to even remember it there. So let's bring that back down to a nice low level. All right, and we'll just cycle again. So that's the low, there's the standby, there's my memorized level. Turn it off at the tail cap, turn it back on, there we go, back up at full power. So. Fairly straightforward, easy to use. You can double-click the switch to get access to a fairly debilitating strobe. Click it again, you get into a standby. Again, we come back into high. So, fairly straightforward. It's there if you want it. It does not memorize that being in that mode. You turn it back on, you come back into a constant output mode. This is actually a very nice interface, one that I like. It's the same on the 7G3 as it was on the 7G5. So. Really, it just comes down to build, what size light you want, and what kind of throw you want. It's a fairly good beam. I don't know how you can see that there. It actually has a fairly defined hotspot, a little hard to tell on the camera. And the color balance is off here in my office. It's actually a very, maybe a creamy white around the hotspot, but actually kind of pinkish, if anything, in tone in the middle. Of course, your mileage can vary. You're bound to find different types of exact tints across the lights. But overall, as you'll see, the light, because of the deep reflector, has a fairly sharply defined hotspot and throws fairly well. The 7G3 throws reasonably well for its class. I don't have a battery in there right now. But of course, it's not going to throw as well or as far as the 7G6. That's hard to show here in the office. So I suggest you check out my full review for details and overviews of the two lights and their relative performance. Both builds, I think, are good. I prefer the 7G6 build for a number of reasons. One being, of course, you know, it does have a larger throw, which is popular for many. You have the, you know, grip ring. You've got the stainless steel bezel with the crenellated cutouts. You can see if the light is on. You have anodized tail cap. You know, all those different features. But then again, if you want the more slimline, you can get basically the same interface and very similar performance in this more, you know, small build. So the choice is up to you. Two options that are available from Crelant. Grip, I think, is pretty good on this model. Again, the knurling is not overly aggressive. It's actually fairly smooth. But between the clip and all the other features, especially around, you know, the head, I would definitely say that's an above average grip. So I'm not too worried about dropping the light. Now, if you want to see how the lights perform to other ones that I've reviewed, check out my full reviews at Candle Power Forums. You'll find them in the review form under the username selfbuilt, or at Flashlight Reviews under the username, actually under my own personal site. So, hope you found that useful. Thanks for your time.